Welcome back. As you can see, a little bit of a different camp with a different bag and different kit. So yeah, it's a bit heavier, a bit bigger, but the reason behind that is the woods. So as it's turned into the winter now, you want to keep it a bit warmer. So the kind people at Pomoly have sent us a hot tent. I've got the Hussar plus two and the stove I've got, as you can see here, this is them, shall I say, is the Oroqen mini 3. Some nice features on that. I've already burnt it in, so we'll get a good look at that later. I've never used it in the hot tent. The hot tent to sell, the SR2 Plus, hasn't been out yet, so it's all about first impressions on this camp and the first pitch, so you'll be going through it as much as I'm going through it. But I've checked the contents, because I didn't want to come here with something missing. Contents seem really good, quality seems really good, the weight's not too bad, the tent's about 4.5 kilos. It's about 6.7 for the stove, so not bad. And they are going to be weighty, unless you're going super light, but I want a comfort, so that's what I chose. So yeah, let's get these set up. As you can see, the woodland is cell, lovely, super quiet to be honest with you. So I've got a bit of a rough pitch in mind, but we'll double check it, get ourselves sort of check the ground and then go from there. So pitch wise, area I'm going to choose is this nice flat area. The tent to sell is 4 meters square, so that there will be ideal, or further down. So yeah, that there, nice and dry. I'll just give it a little bit of a clear up, and we'll start from there. Just making sure there's no sharp twigs or anything that's going to be sticking through the tent into the tub. The ground sheet should be doing its job, but well, we've got to double check. Now with the ground clear, let's get the ground sheet down and start from there. As you can see, I've turned it around a little bit. Fire's on that side. Everything else will be on this side. So that'll be where the room is. That's a fire with the flame retardant sheet. So yeah, impressed with the ground sheet so far. And adjusters on every point. About the perfect size, so yeah. Let's get the tent up. Bag is a really big size, so I don't think it'll be a struggle getting everything back in. Packs are room in that. Does also come with straps, so that is very handy keeping it together. Pegs. Let's have a look at them. Everyone likes a nice peg, and it does matter for 9-inch stakes. Now look at them. Really good, solid aluminium, lightweight, but yeah, really strong. Yeah. First proper look at them, I knew I had them, but I'm very impressed with them. So yeah, they have done really well on this. I have had tents off companies before, and that is a massive letdown. Yeah, having it all in one kit with good pegs. So what my plan is to get these, put them all in, and then put the outer on top of it, sort of how you do a land shan. There's no instructions to it, so let's give it a go. this is a pole, never been out the bag. Let's see what it's like. Nice sort of Dyneema cords on the bag as well. Yeah, not bad. Very nice. Still in this new packaging, as you can see, so yeah. All interlinked with an elastic cord, so you know everything goes in the right place. So as you can see, we've got sort of a lantern holder there, which is really good, and that is the top end. Coming down over, it goes to the bottom, which goes to a thicker section. So what you can do is, if I keep a hold of that, just press that there and adjust it throughout all these holes. So yeah, let's pull that out. So yeah, it's pulled out there, as you can see, goes all the way down. I don't know what setting it's meant to be at, but we'll find out, we'll put it in. That goes up and into a cover there, reinforced over nylon. Very well put together, and it has a clip on just for the top. All we've got to do now is put our top cover on there with elastic cords. Being 6'2" is pretty handy. So far, as you can see from the pitch, it's nice and taut all round. Inside, same lovely space. Once you can see where the fire's going, yeah, nice and taut. Really happy with that. The adjustment on there to the bottom, you can see, goes all the way up here. So you can have this really high if you want, which will allow a lot of ventilation through, which would be ideal. But at the minute, I've got it set for sort of the winter. It is cold at the moment, getting to freezing currently where we are in the UK. So yeah, just getting them down a little bit will help. As you can see, the midges are rife. If you're looking at that, you can easily get four people in. Two at the back side, over there, one down there and one here. If you didn't have the room in, so yeah, really big tent. Maybe that's why they call it the plus. So for the inner, it attaches using these points here, onto the pegs. It allows it to come in. Pull that onto the peg. As so, plenty of adjustments, we can bring that room in if I want by just pulling on there. Yes, it does come with two doors, so it does make setting it up a little bit easier. Just got to put this point in and then the centre point. Now all I've got to do with this is plug it in the top and tighten it up. And that's the room up. So this is it with the room in. Let's have a little look. The adjustment's really good because you can have it more that way than this way. Either or, you could use that as storage. The point at the corner, these toggles here for the door. And then literally it clips on by the hook up there. And literally all you do is pull that strap there. Yeah, very nice. A little bit of a pocket here, if you want to just keep that by itself. Yeah, very nice. Very nice. A nice mesh on there. Cut the tile to the door. Two way zip. Use the right one. Inside, it is absolutely massive. It is huge. We have got another door at the back there, which lets a little bit more air through. It's just for the back. Yeah, you can open that. Pocket there. Pocket on that side. It's a nice deep tub, so if you ever come into contact with water, I think you will be dry. Yeah, door rolls back into there. I've got a pocket on the top of the side. Pocket on the top there. And a lantern hook. So yeah, very simple, but it has a lot in it. Surprisingly, the zips on here are a two-way zip, so when it is nice and hot inside and you want to vent some air, you can just pull the top down and get some air through without taking off. So yeah, nice to see that on a hot tent. So the Oroqen Mini 3 by Pomoly. Now that's a feature. Top tables, they do come off, you can invert them and use them as a handle. So yeah, nice little feature. Inside, we have everything. That there is to go on the top of the stove. Just keeps it down in the bar window, so yeah. Poker. And the full chimney set. So all in, a great little compact stove. As you've seen, everything goes inside. Features on the front of it are the ashtray. Ashtray, sure said. And then you've got the door, which is obviously glass, where you lock in. Other features are the legs built in, refractory glass. We do have a second burn chamber here, so the smoke will be burnt off and the air goes into the top, circulates down and under for a better burn, and it cleans the windows. So yeah, nice little feature. First of all, we need to get this stove jack cut, because it's not cut, it's a full piece of fabric. Get that cut and then get this built up. This is where we need to cut a hole. You can take it off, but yeah, I'm going to leave it on just for a bit of a centre hole. We'll go with that, try it in, see what it's like. So first of all, you need the damper on, put that on, and then we'll go from the top to get that in. So now that's in place, everything's straight, there's no tension, and it isn't sitting against the sides. Time to get the rest of the kit in, starting with the bedroom. That's the setup done. I've got the snug pack on the big Agnes on the cot bed. See, the length is from either end, corner to corner, but if you were to put that on the floor, it will be massive. You can see the gap on that side and on that side, and room on the other. So it is a true two man. It is absolutely massive. I'll show you in the moment I take it all out, I'll lie down and show you. Bags there, kits under there like sleep clothes, etc. Cooking equipment, just need to put the logs in and we're done. A little bit of lighter stuff, get that on first. A little bit of Woodland to get a feather stick made. All the wood is now chopped up into sections, so we've got the thicker bits at the back and coming down over to the thin at the front. Fire kit, So everything's all set up in there, and a beer in hand. So yeah, nice little bit of chill time, and then the fire's going on. Temperatures are now dropping, so it's time to get the fire on. I made my own fire lighting kit, so I'm wanting to get into the bushcraft and stuff a bit more. It's been many years, so inside this kit, I've got my fat wood, I've got a few pads with some Vaseline in, and I've also got my ferro rod there. So I'm going to try and use that to start the fire. A few bits of shavings of what I was doing earlier, so yeah, let's see if I can get this alight. So I want to make a bed for it, and then build it up from there, and then once we get this alight, it'll be food time. Wow, well, we'll see. First impressions of this, with the heat coming off in this tent, it is really hot. Really feel it. Might be little, but it does pack a big punch.
Wow, what a setup this is. Got the coma lamp up there, keeping it bright. The Pomoly stove doing its thing.
This fire is very warm. I did think it was small. I didn't think it was going to be big enough, but yeah, really hot. It is packing out some heat. So I'm just loading up with some of the small blocks. At first, I've got some bigger ones for later. I've got me three piles sitting there. Small, medium, and large, so yeah. Get the small ones out of the way with, as you can see. Yeah, burning up lovely. So for tonight, I've got a nice ribeye steak, some peppercorn sauce, nice little bit of broccoli in that. So first of all, I'm going to get that broccoli on, heat it up, and the carrots as well, because I've got some carrots, get them all nice and done, get them nice and soft to how I like them, and then put the steak in and chuck them all back in. Can't beat a bit of Northern Monk. I must say, you can't beat a bit of this. If you can hear that hissing, the Coleman lamp up there. Absolutely fantastic. Can't believe how warm this is. Yeah, many adventures to be had. That's food out the way with, and it was absolutely lovely. I'm really impressed with the stove and how fast it heated the cast iron pan. So I'm really happy with that. It lets up a lot of heat. The wood selection I brought with us wasn't massive, and I think that will do for the night definitely. It's burning the wood well. I've got a half dampened at the moment, just so I don't let out any embers, which will put holes on the side, but it doesn't need to be a full. I've got the bottom open at a 3/4 on the inlet, and it's doing well. But yeah, pull the sides up, just get a bit of light through and enjoy it. But so far, so good. It's a nice calm night, a nice chill night. There's no wind, so I haven't got the guy lines out, but I'm really enjoying this. good morning. As you can hear, the birds are up, so I'm up as well. A lovely sleep, and I must say this thing, the heat this puts out, unbelievable. I think I overestimated it slightly, so I would say, but yeah, cracking. Mini 3, you can see the size of it, and this tent was absolutely boiling last night. So yeah, lovely warm sleep. It got down to 2 degrees outside, so yeah, didn't feel that at all. I'm really happy with the setup. Yeah, time to get a hot chocolate on the go. Nice, warm, easy morning. How nice it feels to be back out in nature. Just listen. Them sounds. So then, let's get a look at this space. Size wise, absolutely massive. So I'm 6'2", my feet are just near the bottom there. Head's up there, so yeah. Get one adult here, another there. Easy to get another one there, so three man to me. Here's a two man, it's called the Hex Peak. It is a two man, the Hussar, plus two. And I think the plus two is coming from the height and a little bit more room that you get within here, but yeah, absolutely massive. You could even get someone a bit shorter that way, over a few people. Yeah, well, the cot bed in does come up a bit, but leaves you a lot of room under here and a lot of room at the back. I like this little feature of the door there. Very nice. The fly net that's in here, the midge net, however you want to call it. Very fine, really good quality as well. Impressed with the size of it. Absolutely cracking setup, to be honest with you. And if you don't want to use this, you don't have to. I've got the ground sheet. It wouldn't matter if you had that or not. You can still get plenty of people around the fire. The rain's now come in, so it is definitely time to pack down. So the inside's all empty. All I've got left in is the stove. I've got the door a little bit shut. Try and keep the water off. So let's get the stove packed down, which will consist of taking the chimney off, emptying the ash, and then cleaning all the inside out, which I've got a little trick for that, but it'll only work if you've got a Ryobi garage blower. Now that the chimney's off, the damper's off, actually empty the ash, empty the stove, put the sides down, and then put the chimney back inside of it, and it goes back in its carry bag. Simple as that. Ryobi garage blower, when you get home you can do this, but I brought it with me, so I'm two out of the way. So now that's the stove all clean, we certainly need to put the chimney in and the sides on. As you can hear, it really is chucking it down with rain, so I've got to dry this thing out when I get home. So yeah, let's get this put away. Here's a little bit of a knack to doing it, I'm still working it out. It's a very tight fitment, but it does work. As I'm going around to disconnect the room from these points, I'll show you how waterproof this tent is. It literally doesn't want to stick. And a bit of water has came in so far, while it's been raining, but it is holding the cell well. as always, crack the tensioners off, so the next time you put it down you can re-tension it, if not you're faffing on what it is. Pull the tab and it's done. As always, leave no trace, left as it was. A little bit of a dry patch there where the temp was. The setup of last night, which was absolutely fantastic. Pomoly has pulled it out of the bag for the quality of their products. So the Hussar Plus 2 and the Oroqen Mini 3 Stove, both fantastic. The quality, second to none. I've had tents from other companies in the past, which don't seem right. When you're buying them, things aren't right. You change your pegs, you change guy lines, you change other things. Guy lines, fantastic. Nice metal hooks on them. Didn't use them, but had a good inspect of them. The pegs are 9-inch stakes. Really good. Couldn't recommend them anymore, especially for a tent like this, because pegs are a massive letdown in most of them. So yeah, really happy with that. Ground sheet nice and thick. The hydrostatic head, which is there. A few more of the tent specs there on the tent. Great, no water come through. The water was just gliding off it. So yeah, really happy with the tent. All in all, very easy to put up. It's so simple. No instructions. Peg it out, put the pole in, different tension points, and that's it. The room inside of it, nice and easy. So you've got a bit of movement on that, and tension the top of that. One clip, done. Easy as that. The centre pole itself does have a lantern hanger on it, so that is very good as well. The ground sheet is very thick. The fire retardant piece, very thick as well, so the ground sheet itself doesn't let any water through. And it's heavy duty and it will last a long time with chairs and wear. I think getting a lot of traffic on it, it'll be fine. The Mini 3 stove, perfect. Absolutely bang on. The top table of it with the sides, great. But the glass on the side provides a lot of light, and on the front, so it does add that therapeutic sort of effect of it. It is absolutely stunning. You've got your vent on the front, you've got your damper on the top, and then also above the glass window, you have the second burn chamber. So when you open that up, air comes in down past the window and cleans the window, so it does keep them a lot cleaner. All the legs are built in. It is literally so compact, everything goes in it and comes out of it, and it's great. Absolutely fantastic. The heat that comes off it, unbelievable. Absolutely unbelievable. It was melting in that tent last night, so yeah, really impressed with it. So I really enjoyed this camp, and I hope you guys have too. It's nice to be out in the woods, enjoying nature, staying warm. Hot tent, it's fantastic for being in the woods, but you can go on campsites too. You can take them wherever you want, to be honest with you. Any questions, drop them in the comments, whether it's regarding this setup, any other setup, or anything in general. Drop them in the comments and I'll get back to you, because I enjoy speaking to people in the comments section too. If you haven't already, do consider subscribing. I have got a few giveaways coming up. One of them is next week, so if you are a subscriber, then you will be in with a chance of winning. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.